She's a prayer warrior, down on her knees, wrestling with power and principalities, standing in the gap for others, for her sisters and...
Good evening, prayer warriors. This is Champions TV. The program is Prayer Warrior Show. I'm glad you are watching us. And this is the month of May, the month that we promise we have good things for you. For the mothers outside there, we have goodies for you. And in the studio, we have Pastor Gladys. She'll be speaking for mothers outside there. You know, mothers, they are good and they are key in our lives. She'll teach us the meaning of the mother and why we need to appreciate them. Stay tuned, relax and enjoy. And call your mom and tell her that you love her and you care for her. Let her know that you are thinking about her. Karibu sana, Pastor Gladys.
Good evening, viewers. It's another wonderful day that the Lord has given us. And you are tuned, I believe that you are going to be blessed today. I want us to start with a word of prayer. Our dear loving Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for this lovely, wonderful evening that you've given unto us. We thank you that you have taken good care of us, especially on this Mother's Day. We commit and dedicate this program into your hands, that as we begin, you begin with us and you continue with us to the very end. We thank you for hearing our prayers and we honor you for answering it because we have prayed in Jesus' name. Today, the 12th of May, 2019, I want you to know that it is Mother's Day. Mother's Day is celebrated all over the world. On this special day, on the Mother's Day, I want to speak to us on the subject, the love of a mother. All the mothers who are listening, I want to speak about the love that God has given us as mothers to the children that we have mothered. Let us start by asking ourselves one very pertinent question, and the question is, who is a mother? I know we all have different answers to this question because it all depends on how you relate with your mother. Some of us know their mothers as the best people in this whole world. Some of us, we are not sure, and so I'm not ignorant, all of you, whichever category you are in, you are listening and you have tuned to this program. For me, a mother, I want to use an acronym of the word mother. What does M stand for? M stands for a mentor. The mother is the first mentor of a child. And so your mommy and my mommy, they were the first mentors that we ever knew. O stands for an overseer. Your mommy and my mommy and mothers who are listening, they are overseers to their children. They see that everything is working well for their children. T stands for a teacher. The first teacher that ever spoke to you as a son or as a daughter, it was your mother. And so a mother is also a teacher. She is also a helper. H stands for a helper. When you did not know what to do, when you had no idea who you are, the mother was always there to help you. She's an encourager. As a child grows up, a mother takes time to encourage. I know we are living at a time and a season when even in our schools, as early as in primary school, sometimes we get discouraged. We are also in some places of work where we get a lot of discouragement. And so a mother is an encourager. And finally, and the R stands for reliable. Reliable friend. There is no other friend and reliable friend like a mother. And so I want you to know a mother is a mentor, she's an overseer, she's a teacher, she's a helper, she's an encourager, and she's a reliable friend. A mother could also go for this that I've also called. M stands for million things she has done for me. A mother does 1,001 things for a child. So M stands for million things that she has done. O stands for organized. My life to make me who I am today. She organized our lives to make us who we are today. T stands for tears. the tears she shed while she was praying for you. H stands for heart, a pure heart of gold that loves me with an everlasting love. E stands for eyes of love that she has always looked at us, eyes that see even beyond what a child can see. And R stands for right, and the right she will always be. Moms will always be right. Put them all together, they spell the word mother, a word that means a world to me. Mothers are known to be life carriers, caregivers, supporters, provider, physically and emotionally. They are burden bearers, attention provider, and the rest is endless of what mothers do. I believe you must have heard great testimonies of world figures who attribute their greatness to their mothers. George Washington, the first American president, said, "My mother was the most beautiful woman I ever saw. All I am, I owe to my mother. I attribute my success in life to the moral, intellectual, and physical education I received because of my mother." Abraham Lincoln, the 16th American president, said, All that I am or ever hope to be, I owe to my angel mother." Washington Irving, the American best story writer, said, "A mother is the most true friend we have. When a heavy and a sudden burden trials falls upon us, when adversity takes place of prosperity, when friends who rejoice with us in our sunshine days desert us, when troubles thickens around us, a mother still clings to us and endeavor by her kind words and counsel to dispel the clouds of darkness around us. A mother causes peace to return to our heart." Steve Wonder, a gospel singer, said, "Mama was my greatest teacher, a teacher of compassion, a teacher of love, a teacher of fearlessness. If love is sweet as a flower, then my mother is that sweet flower of love." Edwin Chapin, an American preacher and editor, said, "No language can express the power and the beauty of a mother." Bill Sanders said, an American evangelist, said, "I don't believe there is a devil enough in hell to pull a boy out of the arms of a godly mother." Wow, what a confession. A mother is your first friend. She is genuine, she is loving, she is caring, and she is the best friend. Lately, the young people have called the word BFF, meaning best friend forever. And I'm here this afternoon to let you know, or this evening to let you know, your mother is your best friend forever. Friends sometimes can leave you. The best friends can come into your life. You trust them. You go a long way with them. You walk with them. You share yourself with them. But I want you to know and to understand that mother is genuine. She will never leave you. Some friends you pour your heart to, you will tell them everything about yourself. And somewhere along the way, there are some of those friends who sometimes will end up leaving you. But a mother is a best friend forever. BFF. Mothers are known to be great achievers in family, particularly in child rearing. It is important to understand that lately, a mother is the one who goes to the labor ward, and you find lately, of course, they are the doctors, the gynecologists. Most of them are also mothers. So this child is born by a mother. The doctor who is receiving the child is a mother. The doctor who is taking care of the child is a mother. And so, in all aspects of life, a mother is very, very, very important. For all the fathers who are listening to this program this evening, I want you to know the best gift you can give to your children is to let them know that you love their mother. The best gift you can give to your children is to let them know that you love their mother. That is the best thing that any father can give to the children. When the children know that their father loves the mother, they have that freedom, they have that peace, they have that joy. Even when life doesn't seem to work as it ought to be, a child that knows that the father and the mother are together, is a child that is encouraged, is a child that is firm, is a child that is able to stand even in the storms of life because she knows or he knows the goodness of the mother or what the mother has done. Proverbs 31:10 to 31 is dedicated to give guidance to the woman or a mother. I would like to read just a bit of it, not all of it, but I'll read it some verses, and I'll leave the others. So please follow up with me. Who can find a righteous wife? For her worth is far above rupees. The heart of her husband, the Bible is quick to mention about her husband, safely trust her, so he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and willingly works with her hand. Verses 25. Strength and honor are her clothing. She shall rejoice in the times to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom. Mothers open their mouths with wisdom. And on her tongue is the law of kindness. She watches over the ways of her household. She is in control of her household. Her children, they rise up and call her blessed. I wonder what your children call you. The children of the proverb, that one woman, when they rise up, they would call her blessed. And her husband also, and he praises her. Does your husband praise you? The husband of the proverb, that's one woman, the Bible says he praises his wife. Many daughters have done well, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is passing, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hand, and let her own works praise her in the gate. Proverbs 31:10 is dedicated to give guidance to a mother and to a woman. Mother's attribute from this scripture we have read. Number one, she is worthy. She is praising, according to verses 11. For her worth is far above rupees. A mother, a wife, cannot be equated to any amount of money. We talk of Kenya shillings. She cannot be equated to any amount of money. She is above any amount of money. She is trustworthy. According to, of course, verses 11b, the heart of her husband savory trust her. And I remember I have asked you a question. The mother who is listening to me, does your husband trust you? She is a hard worker. I cannot be able to explain how important it is to be a hard worker. The Bible says God will bless the work of our hands. And so I want to believe all of us as mothers, so that we may be able to bring up a godly generation, we have to work with our own hands. So that even as we work, we will be a testimony to our sons, to our daughters, so that even when we are gone, our children will not just go to the waste. Children will not just go to the waste, because they will have learned from the mother, they will have learned from the father, and they too will be good, and they'll be hard workers. She is a hard worker. She is wise. She opens her mouth with wisdom. We all know that wisdom is important. We all need to be wise mothers, so that even when we talk to wisdom, we are talking that which will help them, not only today, but even in the days to come. So a woman, or a mother for that matter, that we are talking about today, and the love of a mother, I want you to know she is wise. May we all be wise mothers as we continue to bring up our children.
We are going for a short commercial break. We will be right back after this.